Hi, I'm Phil Davis, and I'm one of the judges for the BCPS Film Expo. And for the middle school animated GIF category, I chose the film, or the GIF, Melee by Xander Olive. And the reason I chose this is that in such a short amount of time, it accomplishes so much. It has character development, there's conflict, the shot selection is pretty incredible for such a short little mini film, and the animated action was excellent in its execution. So well done, Xander. Good job.
My first pick is A Memorable Routine. I thought this had a really unique and strong visual design to it. I love the collage of photos and illustrations. The texture of the entire piece was really strong stylistically. Great sound design and music choice to it. Overall, the piece shows a really strong sense of style, storytelling, and mood.
I mean, I found a slug. Take that thing back outside. It needs some salt. Why do we need to take it outside? It's just such a cute little slug. Why can't we keep it as a pet? Why can't we keep it? It's so cute. Sunset! No! What are you doing? No! No! You're poisoning Sunset!
Die!
No!
I got a feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. A feeling That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight.
I can't believe Emmy did that to Sunset. He was my friend. Wait, is that Sunset? Are you alive? Oh my god! There's so many. Emmy, there's more! What are you talking about?
That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. I feel it. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That
there's more. There's a lot more. Sunset is alive. I doubt that. Sunset is alive, I swear. Sure. It has a significant other. I guess I'm not a slug hater, it's fine. I'll put the salt down. Yay! Now Emmy's not a slug hater anymore. And this is why we don't kill our friends.
Hi students, once again, I am so proud and pleased to judge your works of art. I am honored to be given the opportunity for you to raise your bar of creativity. Your creativity in film allows you to create the best work that you can because the world needs your creativity and you need to grow in the phase of art that you want to take it. It hasn't been an easy task making a selection. I picked a live action type film titled The Life of Sunset by Brianna Taylor and Emmy London. Brianna and Emmy, your clarity and mixture of the audio, musical score, and the soundtrack really nailed the smooth transition while focusing on the subject. The clarity of using the camera, its focus, and lighting, camera movement was well done. It depicted the composition in a very professional film standard. The effective use of your editing and the continuity in your transition held the piece really together. Your creative style using the medium was well done. And the creative usage and technique of the camera technique was professionally done. Looking at Sunset and the intent that it was given just allowed the viewers to really see Sunset for the name in which that it was really created. Good job.
Hi, I'm Phil Davis, and I'm one of the judges for the BCPS Film Expo, and for the high school animated GIF category, I chose the one created by Nathaniel Fink. It was the colorful cube jumping out of the water and then falling back underwater. The GIF has a beautiful sense of depth and color and wonderful timing and motion. It's a joy to watch, so well done, Nathaniel.
someone to follow follow. In your book, baggy, your polo. Mundakujan, see me, Jimmy Jalla. Tell me at the Sahon, Kamisoto, Kamisoto. A job for job. If I look a look a look at the papa. Sit the night for the club, you could turn up. Everybody at the park, the park. I want the car in position. I don't go let anyone control. Anything I want to, I will do. Back bush. I want the car in position. I don't go let anyone control. Anything I want to, I will do.
Hi, my name is Jeff Otradovich. I'm a video production instructor at the Sheffield Institute for the Recording Arts. For the promotional video category, this year, my pick is Viviana Stasiu. Your shot selection and the color and the motion in your video really all came together to make something really beautiful. I love the use of slow motion and the use of very interesting light. The piece just really worked together with your use of music and really all came together to make something really beautiful. So that's my pick for promotional video.
Hi students, it has been a pleasure judging your works of art. I am honored to be given the opportunity. The gift of your film expressions continue to raise the bar for creating good film. Keep doing your best work, and your discipline will take you to a higher phase of creating work. I picked a short form video titled Peaceful Scenery. The film depicted a strong resolution image that fully composed the composition, which was enhanced by lighting. The film's fluidity, along with the smooth transition, captured a sense of creative calm while still focusing on subject. The film's creative style demonstrated a strong use of color, mixed medium, artwork, imagery, camera movement, technique, and originality. The film's artistic intent reflected a real and true sense of a peaceful scenery. Great job.
Hello, Dave again. My selection for Best High School Animated Short goes to Emma Plunkert's Tea Time. Honestly, I was just blown away by the quality of this short. Your animation was fluid and beautiful. You managed to capture a lot of subtle detail in the way the human figure moves through space. Your design was, though simple, was clever and beautiful. Your concept was delightfully surreal, and even your sound design was immersive and thorough. This is silly and specific, but hands are tricky things to draw, let alone animate, and you had a few shots in there that I had to watch over and over just to appreciate your execution. Well done. I really look forward to seeing more animation from you in the future. Thank you.
Emma, I very much enjoyed your animation Tea Time. I thought the pace of your narrative development was very precise and clear. I liked the simplicity of your drawings and your use of block colors. And I very much enjoyed the animation of your characters' movements. This was very convincing, as simple as it was. I also liked your choice of sounds, your use of Foley sounds in coordination with some musical sections. And also, of course, the rumbling, the ominous rumbling at the beginning. This is very good work, Emma. Congratulations.
Horticulture here at Delaney is a multifaceted course. It is a very hands-on course, a very open-minded course where you're learning about plants. You're learning about the anatomy of pushing this stem through the soil. What if you just push this through the soil? Would it wipe away all of the rooting hormone? Yeah, so that's the mechanics of it. You're learning about propagation. This one's going to be a little more tricky. Cut it at a 45 degree angle. Remove the lower leaves. You even dive into a little bit of agriculture. We do have a greenhouse. We grow plants. We have several fundraisers during the year. And several food field trips, along with food days, where you'll be eating food based on certain types of plants. For details about some of the food days are always linked to something in horticulture. For example, we have Potato Day, where students will bring in and make things based on potatoes. We'll talk about the history of potatoes, potato diseases, potato health, potato culture, and where they're grown in the United States and around the world. We do the same thing with maple. Maple is a very unique thing here in the northern part of the United States, where that maple syrup is collected. 40 gallons of maple sap boiled down to make 1 gallon maple syrup. We learn about the history of it, the production of it, what's at risk, what are the risks to the production, and of course, how sweet it is.
In this episode, we look at John Ender's teaching the art of gardening, aka horticulture, to students in Delaney High School, located in an old suburban town adjacent to the city of Baltimore. Delaney is one of the only schools that still teaches this almost lost art. Horticulture provides a range of green career paths, including greenhouse production, wholesale brokers, commercial nurseries, garden centers, florists, and landscape design and construction firms.
Pressure with your hands on there. Ready to go. Yeah, don't push down on it. Even pressure.
There are also green jobs in private and community gardens, municipal parks, and state or national reserves. Heaven only knows why humans would have interest in plants, given that they may seem like lifeless inanimate objects, unlike animals, like cats, dogs, lions, tigers, and fish. But at the same time, just like how lifeless objects can turn on our cranial light bulbs, but at the same time having the benefit of them being just as meaningful as animals. That probably answers the question. It also helps that plants sustain all life on this planet. They give us oxygen, food, water, shelter, and endless sources of beauty and delight in an extraordinary diversity ranging from tiny wolfia to 300 feet high redwood trees. Since there is no known war between flowers and other flowers, plants are also proof that a forever peaceful and loving society is possible. Also, just like animals, plants provide us with food, fiber, shelter, medicine, and fuel. The basic food for all organisms is produced by green plants. In the process of food production, oxygen is released. This oxygen, which we obtain from the air we breathe, is essential to life. In a world where there is proof of the planet's health being fragile, there is just as much proof that there is always hope that the environment does get stronger health by adaptation. But still, that doesn't mean that we should abandon taking care of it, even if sometimes it seems like all hope is lost. Some may even argue that a bit of doomsday and pessimistic thinking can force things to get better quickly. Whatever that is true or not is a whole different story. Strangely enough, there can also be contradictions in how things in nature can strive to live.
Strangely enough, there can also be contradictions in how things in nature can strive to live. An example of this is how certain insects are beneficial to killing off other bacteria caused by other bugs. Similar in certain quirks that Mr. Enders has. Still though, at least living things on Earth are free to make mistakes and not be perfect. A key benefit that Mr. Ender does that I think more teachers should do is even for the students that seem like they are not interested in the subject matter at first. He has a certain magic to make them interested. Not only does gardening benefit the health of the earth by plants acting as highly effective air cleaners, absorbing carbon dioxide, plus many air pollutants, while releasing clean oxygen and fragrance. But gardening can also contribute to good health by providing healthy fruits and vegetables for adequate nutrition. When a household grows fresh fruits and vegetables, the entire household tends to eat more fruits and vegetables. Children who participate in growing vegetables are more likely to try or eat a broader selection of vegetables. It is well known that plants are an excellent source of fiber, vitamins, and minerals essential to health. Gardening can meet our needs for personal choice, mastery and competence, and a sense of relationship to others. One, two, designing a garden space. Selecting which plants to grow or even their colors are examples of personal choice. Selecting a preferred garden tool may meet that need for a child in the garden. Growing edible plants or those that are purely ornamental is entirely up to the gardener. Opportunities to achieve success and demonstrate competency abound in the garden. A sense of pride and purpose results from growing and harvesting that first radish or tomato, or from arranging a vase of cut flowers. 15. Success in the garden leads to an increase in self-esteem for both adults and youth. And straight lines, perfection, or even plant death are no cause for concern. Plants teach youth and adults alike about patience, delayed gratification, and nurturing. The garden and its related tasks provide an opportunity to teach work habits by helping in the garden and understanding what it takes to produce food. 5. In terms of horticulture being an art form. Well, think of it as not only art that Mother Nature creates, but kind of like a massive group project that everybody involved with gardening participates in. Like how the process of making a giant statue. Now I want you to imagine a world where the art of gardening doesn't exist. Look depressing, right? Well, that's just the fact about it. Just like with other important art forms, it is extremely important for us as human beings to preserve tradition like this, so art like horticulture can last forever. Because without it, there are dire consequences that are sure to come.
Hi, I'm Joel Baldwin, a member of the Film Expo Committee. I wanted to speak about the documentary selection entitled Horticulture, the Art of Conservation. This is the story of John Enders, one of the few horticulture teachers in Baltimore County. He teaches at Delaney High School. Through a nice variety of shots that show how the class fits into the school climate and provides valuable skills to the students of Delaney High School. The pacing and timing of the film show good planning and drive the viewer to learn more about the program. Enjoy!
I wanted to thank Sam for inviting me to jury this year. It was really exceptional. A great pool of entrants. And my choice for the film in the experimental category was Noise Cancellation by Melanie Sands. It so effectively communicated the kind of anxiety that a student can feel moving through a high school corridor when she's really overstimulated by all of the noise around her, kind of crowding her brain, and the effect of putting on those noise-canceling headphones momentarily to quiet herself. There's so many smart decisions in this film in regard to sound design, the scrubbing through video footage, back and forth motion. It was just exceptionally made, and I want to congratulate the filmmaker again for this very mature work that she has shared with your community and which was my privilege to view. Thank you. My name's Tim Noe, and I'm a professor at UMBC, and I instruct sound design, and so this one landed very effectively for me considering my own professional practice. Thanks so much to everybody.
Tragedy happened around 12:02. early morning, and the suspect is still on the loose. The police believe the suspect is a young woman with short blonde hair. If you have any information about the suspect, please contact the police immediately.
So many murders going on lately. Have you heard about all of them?
Yeah, have you heard about the new murder that's on the loose one?
No. There's one on the loose right now.
Right now, I'm not gonna home.
Like, who even has that?
Yeah, I heard that it was like a whole blood scene.
Really? Wow. Did you hear? I heard there's new information about it. Apparently it's a girl Audrey.
That's insane.
Yeah, I know. I was at the restaurant over there.
My first pick was Fugitive. I really enjoyed this film. I thought it had distinct and strong visual system, really detailed and interesting locations, good camera work and interesting angles, and strong symbolism and imagination to the narrative. I really enjoyed it, and congratulations.
My selection for high school live action narrative went to The Fugitive. This film did an excellent job with creating tension along with music and wonderful shot composition to convey the fugitive state of mind. I also liked how you told information, specifically how your narrative unfolded. It was a slow reveal of information, so you didn't lead with everything right away. You kind of let the audience fill in some blanks, which was really nice. I also liked the use of handheld shots to help create the feel of a woman on the run.